Hello guys, today we are going to discuss understanding quadrilaterals, chapter number 3. In this chapter we are discussing about plane surface, plane curve, polygons and so on. Let's start our video. Plane curve. Plane surface. A flat surface extends in all directions called plane surface. What is the meaning of plane surface? Flat surface extending in all directions. You have a surface, any surface, look like this one, or look like this one. Okay, you have these two surfaces. Now you have to extend. Extend means you have to extrude. Okay, in this, all this, any direction. Okay, that time, that surface is known as plane surface. If that surface is extended in any direction. Okay, suppose you have this one paper. This is the paper. Okay, you can extend this one paper, look like this one, as a rubber, in this direction and in this direction. You can extend this paper in any direction if this is a stretchable. Okay, that time it is a plane surface. Okay, extend means to increase. Okay, in mathematical language, so it is a plane surface. Now the next one is plane curve. Okay, now what is the meaning of plane curve? A curve by joining the number of points. Okay, number of points without lifting the pencil is called plane curve. Okay, suppose you have a plane surface. This is a plane surface. Now this is a plane surface, and on the plane surface you have 4 points. Point number 1, 2, 3, 4. Now first is number of points, joining the number of points. Let's start to join the points. Point 1, 2, 2, 2, 3 and a 4. We stop here or pencil to join to the point number 4 to 1. Now, at point number 4, we lift our pencil. Lift means we just put out our pencil from point number 4. This is the meaning of lifting our pencil. That time, this figure cannot, these two points cannot be joined to each other. That time a figure is generate. Okay, look like this one. This is a open curve. Okay, this is a open plane curve. Okay, if we join the point number 1 to 4, this is a closed curve. Yes or no? We can fill anything in this curve. Yes or no? Okay, that time it is known as closed curve. Okay, so there are the two types of curve. One is open curve and a closed curve. Okay, if the points, all the points cannot be connected to each other, that time the figure is open curve, like all these one. Okay, but if all the points are connected to each other, that time that figure is known as a closed curve. So there are the two types of curve, open curve and a closed curve. Okay, now polygons, closed curve. Okay, first condition is we have to take the closed curve, which are made up of line segments. It's a very important line segments. Okay, whatever the closed curve you are taking, that closed curve are only made up of line segments, only are called polygons. Okay, look at here, we have 1 2 3 4 closed curve. Okay, first closed curve, we have 3 points, 1 2 3, and all 3 points are connected through a line. Line number 1 2 3, this is a closed curve. Yes, this is a closed curve. Here in the next example we have 4 points, and all 4 points are connected through four lines. We can say it's again a closed curve or a polygon. Now in the next third example we have 1 2 3 4 5 6 6 points, but all the six points cannot connected with the line segments. They are joined with some curve, like this one. So we can't say it's a polygon. It's not a polygon, it's simply a closed curve. Similarly, this is a circle, and there is no line segment in a circle. It's simply a curvature. Okay, but it's a closed curve. Okay, so we can't say it's a polygon. So the other two terms are required to make a polygon: closed curve, and second one is line segments. Okay, Now, guys, there is a conclusion or a result. Now, minimum 3 sides are required to draw a polygon. You need minimum 3 sides to draw a polygon. Okay, suppose you have 2 sides, side number 1 and side number 2. It's not a closed curve. Okay, so it can't be a polygon. 1, 2. Okay, it can't be a polygon. But you have 3 sides, 1, 2, 3. It's make a polygon. Which type of polygon? We will discuss later. Classifications of polygon. Now, classifications of polygon on the basis of sides or vertices. So first of all, we have to know what is the minimum vertices. Guys, where I'm going to discuss vertices, okay? You have two lines, okay, line number one and a line number two. Where the two lines are joined or meet or intersect, okay, that is known as vertex. Okay, yes or no? This is a plural and this is a singular. Similarly here, okay, so one line, two line, three line, we have three line, okay, three lines, vertices number one, vertices number two, vertices number three, we have three vertices. Okay, so number of lines equals to number of vertices, or you can say number of sides equals to number of sides equals to number of vertices. This is a guys very important result. Okay, now number of sides, name of the polygon, which kind of polygon is formed, okay, and the figure. If we have three sides, the polygon formed by three sides is triangle. 1, 2, 3 vertices and three lines, you can check, okay, and this is a figure of triangle. 4 quadrilateral, 5 pentagon, 6 hexagon, 7 heptagon, 8 octagon, and so on. Okay guys, so this is a polygon. Now next, diagonals. What is the meaning of diagonals? A line segment joining any two non-consecutive vertices in a polygon called diagonals. Okay, a line segment joining any two non-consecutive vertices. Guys, you know what is the meaning of non-consecutive? In our earlier chapter, linear equation in one variable, consecutive means 1, 3, 5, 7 and so on, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 99 and 100. Okay, these are the meaning of consecutive. Okay, so when you start to join the consecutive vertices in a polygon, it forms a line segment, and that is known as the diagonals. And you can say, or this is another definition, a line segment joining two opposite vertices which are not on same edge called diagonals. Okay guys, this is a formula to find out in any polygon how many diagonals can be formed in any polygon. Okay, that is n minus 3 upon 2. And what is n represents here number of sides. Okay, n represents here number of sides. Okay, number of sides. Now suppose three sides are required to draw a polygon. Okay, so we are taking from the triangle, we have three vertices, 1, 2, 3, and three sides. Okay, this is our formula, n minus 3 upon 2. 3 minus 3 upon 2, 3 multiplied by 0 upon 2 0 upon 2 0, that means there is no diagonals can be formed in a triangle. Can you draw any diagonal? Okay, yes or no? So 0 diagonals. Now quadrilateral, we have 4 vertices, so 4 sides, so n equals to 4 and n minus 3 upon 2, this is our formula. 4 minus 3 upon 2 gives you 2. That means there are the 2 diagonals in a quadrilateral. Okay, there are 2 diagonals can be formed in a quadrilateral. Now what are the diagonals? Now consecutive, point number 1, 2, 3, 4, 1 and 3, yes or no? Odd consecutive numbers. 2 and 4, even consecutive numbers, or you can say opposite vertices. This is a diagonal, diagonal number 1 and a diagonal number 2. Okay guys, I hope you understood the topic. Thank you.